தமிழக ஆளுநரின் உரைக்கு எதிர்ப்பு தெரிவித்து திமுக உள்ளிட்ட எதிர்க்கட்சிகள் வெளிநடப்பு செய்தன. தமிழக சட்டசபையின் முதல் கூட்டத்தொடர் இன்று காலை 10 மணிக்கு துவங்கியது. ஆளுநர் பன்வாரிலால் புரோஹித் சட்டசபையை துவக்கி வைத்து உரை நிகழ்த்தி வருகிறார். இந்த வருடத்தில் நடக்கும் முதல் சட்டசபை கூட்டமாகும். அதேபோல் ஆளுநராக பன்வாரிலால் புரோஹித் நியமிக்கப்பட்ட பின் நடக்கும் முதல் கூட்டத்தொடர் இதுவாகும். கூட்டம் தொடங்கியவுடன் மறைந்த உறுப்பினர்களுக்கு மௌன அஞ்சலி செலுத்தப்பட்டது. இதையடுத்து தமிழில் வணக்கம் தெரிவித்து தனது உரையை தொடங்கினார் ஆளுநர். ஆனால் ஆளுநர் உரைக்கு எதிர்ப்பு தெரிவித்து எதிர்க்கட்சிகள் கூச்சல் குழப்பத்தில் ஈடுபட்டனர்.
Please, let me continue. Honorable member, please, utkaranga, please.
எதிர்க்கட்சிகளின் கடும் கூச்சல் குழப்பங்களுக்கு மத்தியில் உரையாற்றி வருகிறார் ஆளுநர் பன்வாரிலால். இந்த அரசில் செய்த திட்டங்களை பட்டியலிட்டார் ஆளுநர். அதேபோல் வரும் காலத்தில் செய்யப்படும் திட்டங்கள் குறித்தும் பேசி வருகிறார். அதோடு மட்டுமின்றி மத்திய அரசின் திட்டங்களை பாராட்டி முன்னெப்போதும் இல்லாத வகையில் ஆளுநர் உரையில் இடம்பெற்றிருப்பது வியப்பை ஏற்படுத்தியுள்ளது.
Defecation free status under the Swachh Bharat Mission. I am confident the state of Tamil Nadu will be able to achieve higher level of accomplishment in realizing the national goals under the Swachh Bharat Mission. State government is fully committed to continuously upgrading the urban infrastructure to cater to the needs of the growing urban population in Tamil Nadu. I am happy to note that the central government's smart cities and Atal Mission for rejuvenation and urban transformation schemes are being implemented with full fervor. The Government of India has approved 10 cities in Tamil Nadu under the Smart Cities Program and 33 urban local bodies under the Amrut Scheme for the upgradation of urban infrastructure. I am glad to inform this August House that so far the Government of India has released ₹828 crore and ₹951 crore for smart cities and Amrut scheme respectively. The state is also implementing World Bank funded Tamil Nadu Sustainable Urban Development Project, thus giving a further impetus to urban infrastructure development in the state. This government is committed to creating slum-free cities and hut-free villages in the state. Towards achieving this objective, a mission for housing for the poor has been launched to systematically bridge the gap between the demand and supply of both rural and urban housing in Tamil Nadu. The state is in the forefront in the country in constructing free houses for the rural poor. Under the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana and the Chief Minister's Solar Power Greenhouse Scheme, since the inception of Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana scheme, the Government of India has approved the construction of 3.84 lakh housing units at a total project cost of ₹14,462 crores. I thank the central government for releasing ₹1,498 crores so far under this scheme. The government has already constituted a shelter fund for raising funds to provide housing to the urban poor. Legislation will be brought in the current session of the assembly, enable the levy of shelter charges. The Town and Country Planning Act 1971 will also be suitably amended, provide statutory backing for the issue of transferable development rights to appropriately compensate those who give up their land for urban development projects like road widening. A secondary market for TDRs will also be developed through an appropriate mechanism following the enactment of the Real Estate Regulation and Development Act by the Parliament. State government has also notified the RERA rules. This is expected to regulate the real estate sector effectively and thus protect the interests of the consumers. Chennai Metro Rail has emerged as a boon to the people of the Chennai metropolis and has been gaining immense popularity. It is expected that the remaining part of the underground section of phase 1 of the Chennai Metro Rail project will be operational in stages by the end of 2018. Phase 1 extension covering a length of 9 km from Vasarmenpet to Thrivatriyur, Vimkunagar is also under implementation. 3 more metro rail corridors covering a total distance 117.5 km under phase 2 of the Chennai Metro Rail project at an estimate of ₹79,962 crore have been approved and recommended by the state government to the Government of India for obtaining external aid. I request the central government to accord early approval for phase 2 of the Chennai Metro Railway project. The state government is committed to improving ease of doing business in Tamil Nadu. And as a first step towards honoring this commitment, the Tamil Nadu Business Facilitation Ordinance 2017 has been promulgated. On 28th October 2017, a bill for enacting it will be introduced in the legislature in the current session. As yet another major structural reform initiative, Honorable Chief Minister has launched a web-based online single window clearance portal on 2nd November 2017 that enables investors to obtain the required clearances and renewals across 11 departments. The Business Facilitation Act, when enacted by this August House, will further strengthen the single window clearance system by stipulating timelines for approval, providing for deemed approval for certain clearances. The government has also constituted high-level committee to monitor the disposal of the applications within specified timelines and to act as a grievance redressal forum for investors. The honorable members would recall that the first global investors meet in Tamil Nadu was held in Chennai in September 2015. It was a grand event in which 98 memoranda of understanding were signed, and with investors committing a total investment of ₹2.42 lakh crore in the state across different sectors. I am happy to note that 61 projects that will generate 96,341 jobs and with a total investment of ₹62,738 crore are presently under implementation. The government is actively pursuing the remaining project proposal by providing facilitation services to the investor through the Tamil Nadu Industrial Guidance and Export Promotion Bureau for obtaining statutory clearances. As micro, small and medium enterprises provide large-scale employment opportunities, this government accords high priority for promoting them. His special focus is on the twin goals of promoting entrepreneurship and skill building. The novel initiative of the new entrepreneurship enterprise development scheme has created a favorable climate for budding entrepreneurs build startup enterprises in the state. Government has taken up the development of 4 MSME development projects under the second phase of the JICA-funded Tamil Nadu Investment Promotion Program for establishing infrastructure parks for supporting and hand-holding MSME business. The policy of extending financial assistance to private investors and industrial association in collaboration with Tamil Nadu Small Industry Development Corporation for promoting new industrial estates will continue. Tamil Nadu has always been at the forefront in the country in providing quality health care and enabling people to lead a healthy life. The state has already achieved the Millennium Development Goals set by the United Nations and the national targets way before the other states, and is also poised to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals.
முன்னதாக ஆளுநர் உரையை புறக்கணித்து திமுக உள்ளிட்ட எதிர்க்கட்சிகள் வெளிநடப்பு செய்தனர். தமிழகத்தில் பேருந்து நிறுத்தம், நீட் பிரச்சனை, ஆர்கே நகர் தேர்தல் என நிறைய விஷயங்களை புயலை கிளப்பி இருப்பதால் இந்த கூட்டத்தொடர் அதிக எதிர்பார்ப்பை ஏற்படுத்தியிருக்கிறது. அதேபோல் முக்கியமாக ஒக்கி புயலும் பிரச்சனையை கிளப்ப இருக்கிறது.